Hey, what's up everyone, and welcome to the School of Personal Finance. In today's video, we're gonna be talking about some spending tips as well as keeping your overall personal finances nice and healthy as we enter this crazy holiday shopping season. Now, there are more options out there. There are different ways that you could buy presents and finance things, hopefully using cash if you're able to. But I'm gonna get into some pros and cons of some different platforms you could use about using credit cards, other ways that you might be able to pay for it, ways to get organized and just have a plan of attack as you go into it so you don't leave yourself with a crazy hangover as we get into 2022. And I just created a shorter video about this over on LinkedIn. I would love to connect with you over there. I'm starting to get more active and communicate more with more and more people. So I'm looking to grow my network. So hit me up over there. All right, let's get to it. All right, so real quick before I jump in, I updated my website, schoolofpersonalfinance.com. I would love for you to go check it out and let me know what you think. So I've added a few different things. The first thing is I added a waiting list for my education center, which I'm planning on launching on January 1st. So I'm gonna have a test group. People are already signing up for that. And I have a form if you would like to sign up for it. Just go to the website, you fill out an email form, and I'll send you instructions on how to join the test group. I would love to have you over there. People that are in the test group, they're gonna get a discount on that, a lifetime discount on being in the education center. And we're gonna have a one-on-one Zoom call because I'd love to get your feedback and see what it is you wanna learn about, how could I improve it, all that type of stuff. So please go join the test group and get involved in creating this content with me. The second thing is that I added what I call power sessions, where if you wanted to work one-on-one with me, you could hire me for a power session where we'll use Right Capital financial planning software and we'll dive in. I'll share my screen. We'll spend an hour going through all of your finances and I'll give you my advice. I'll give you a report with all of my recommendations and everything once we're off. So go check that out. That's over at schoolofpersonalfinance.com under power sessions. All right, so the holidays are pretty much upon us. And if you don't go in with a game plan, things could get ugly really quick. So I've learned from experience that you have to have some kind of plan of attack when doing this, especially if you have a large family. So like I'm married, I have three kids, I have a bunch of nieces and nephews. So buying presents for everybody, it could get a little bit overwhelming. And here we are, you know, the end of 2021, and what's going on in the world? Inflation is craziness. The supply chain issues, like we've never lived through this before, where we have all these ships in the port sitting in Los Angeles where, you know, there aren't enough workers to get all the stuff off of the boats. It's crazy town. And with prices going up so much, it just adds that much more stress to this holiday shopping season. So the first thing that I suggest that you do is like take a deep breath, you know, and start to plan out in your head, how much money do I really want to spend on everybody this year? And what kind of gifts are really worth giving? Like I always joke with my wife, I hate buying like plastic toys. Like we don't need any more of that stuff. Like I would rather spend our money on better things, on experiences, on investments, on things that could benefit us in the future. I hate having these big bulky toys around the house that eventually we just give away or throw out. So I don't wanna spend any money on that stuff, but I digress. So the first thing that I recommend you do is just come up with a game plan. And what I really like to do is I will write out a list of all of the people that I need to spend money on this year, that I need to buy presents for this year. And I will put an estimated dollar amount next to each one of their names, just so I know how much money I am actually planning on spending throughout the holiday season. All right, so now once you have a pretty good idea of how much you're gonna be spending on your holiday shopping, the next thing that I want you to do, and I talk about this all the time, is to just take inventory and to understand your current situation. So get a very good feel for how you plan on paying for this holiday shopping. Do you have enough cash in the bank that you'll be able to use that? Or do you have credit card debt? And if you do, what I'd love to see you do is to list out all of the credit cards that you use, along with the interest rate that you're currently paying on it, the minimum payment, the balance that you owe, how much availability you have on that credit card, just so you're getting organized and you're starting to put together a plan of attack in your head of what might be the best way for you to approach this spending. Now, obviously, if you have a savings account, if you have money in the bank, if you've been saving for this throughout the year, that's the best way to do it, right? If you could just pay cash for these purchases, or better yet, you use a credit card for all the purchases, earn some rewards points, and then pay it off at the end when you're done, that is how I try to do it. That is the best way to go about it. But if you're not in that situation, if you really don't have a lot of cash in the bank, then you have to start getting strategic and you have to figure out what might be the best way for you. All right, so now that you know where you currently stand with your financial situation, now it's time to strategize a little bit and see what might be the best way for you to spend this money through the end of the year. So a couple of examples might be, like, say that you want to buy a new computer at Best Buy. Should you open up a Best Buy credit card and get maybe 12 months worth of free interest or interest-free payments on that credit card over the 12-month period while you pay that back? Would that be a smart idea for you? Or should you just use an existing credit card that you have to just make it easy and just tack it on to the bill that you're already paying? Or should you maybe apply for a new credit card, maybe through, you know, whatever, through Chase or through a local bank or through Discover, and just get a credit card that maybe has a 0% interest for a certain period of time on any new purchases and use that? Or there's a new option that is becoming very popular, which is the buy now, pay later option through companies like Affirm. And I'm actually going to show you a couple of examples with that. Or here's another idea. Maybe if you do have some cash that you were planning on using, but you also carry credit card debts, maybe what you do is you take the cash, you pay down a low balance credit card to zero so that you wipe the slate on it, and then you use that credit card for the purchases, because at least what that will do is it'll give you then a grace period. So the way credit cards work, if you carry a balance on your credit card month to month and you make a purchase on it, they start charging you interest the day that you make that purchase if you are carrying a balance. So it could become very expensive, and the interest, it really starts to compound on you, and it could get very, very expensive, especially if you're paying like 20% interest. But if you have a credit card that you pay off in full by the due date every month, then what happens when you make a purchase using that card, then you typically don't receive your bill for like a month, right? And then even when you get your bill, you have like 25 days or so before you have to pay that bill in full. And you don't get charged interest during that time. You have what's called a grace period. So paying your credit cards in full every month is a great way to go, because you pay no interest by doing that. But once you carry a balance, even if it's only like $5 and you carry it to the next billing cycle, then what happens is they're going to charge you interest on every purchase the day you make the purchase. So that's why it is super important to pay off those cards in full. All right, let's take a deeper look at those options that I just mentioned. So the first one, let's say, for example, I want to surprise my wife and buy a new outdoor furniture set for her for Christmas, and I'm going to go to Home Depot to do it. And let's say that it costs $4,000. All right, Home Depot has a promotion where they're offering me 0% interest for 24 months. But when I look at that offer, I see that it says it's deferred interest. So it's a promo rate of 0%, but it's a deferred interest promotion. So what does that mean? You have to be very careful with deferred interest. What that means is that they're charging you the interest, all right? They are just deferring it. And as long as you pay the entire balance, so in this case, the $4,000, as long as I pay it off in full by the end of that promo period, in this case, 24 months, then they will not charge me any of that deferred interest. But if I carry any balance, if I slip up and I don't pay the entire $4,000 amount by the end of that 24 months, even if I've paid it all the way down to $200, at the end of that 24 months, if it's not a zero balance, what they will do is they will go back and charge me all of the deferred interest that would have accumulated during those 24 months. So that could be a tremendous number. And it might be a very high interest rate. So what if it's 20%, right? So 20%, I mean, that could be $800 a year on $4,000 if I let it continue to go. So you could get hit with thousands of dollars of deferred interest if you don't pay it off in full. So you have to be very careful when looking at these promotional rates. And then the next option that I talked about was maybe just opening up a 0% promo credit card through, you know, your local bank or through like American Express or Discover, whoever's offering, you know, the best deal at the time. And this could be a smart way to go, especially if you are sure that you could pay off the entire balance during that promo rate. So if it gives you 12 months of interest-free purchases, then if you could pay it off in those 12 months, then at least you're not paying any interest on it. But again, you have to look at your overall financial situation. Obviously, carrying credit card balances is not encouraged encouraged or recommended. But if that's the only way that you're going to be able to purchase, you know, presents this holiday season, then doing it on a 0% credit card, that is a pretty smart way to do it. And now the last thing that we'll touch on and then we'll wrap this thing up is these new buy now, pay later platforms like Affirm. So if you go to like walmart.com or if you go to amazon.com and you go and you make a purchase, you might now see that there is this option to pay through Affirm through monthly payments. And now I bought a Peloton last year and it was through, my payments are through Affirm. So I could have made this the decision to pay for the whole thing up front, and I could have used a credit card or my checking account or whatever, but they had an option through Affirm where I could spread it, I believe it's over 2 years, and it's 0% interest. So I thought to myself, why not? You know, I'll have the monthly payment, it's a much obviously lower payment than if I would have paid the thing in full, and I'm not gonna get charged any interest. And it's a set schedule, it's over 24 months, no ifs, ands, or buts about it. I send them, you know, it's like $72 a month for 24 months and I pay off my Peloton. And I thought this was a pretty good deal. But now if you go to these bigger sites like Walmart or Amazon, who Affirm now is basically on their checkout page, then it's very different. The interest rate that they charge you, it could range from like 10 to 30% based on the amount of the purchase, based on your credit history. So you have to be very careful. Now, I am not a fan of monthly payments. I never think, unless it was a 0% Peloton, but I typically do not think it's a good idea to have monthly payments, because then what you're doing is you are robbing yourself of your future income to pay and consume for things now. And that's typically not a good idea, right? You want to do the opposite. You want to take the money that you make now and you want to invest it for your future. You don't want to tie up your future money on things that you're using now and that you're not going to have much value after you're done using them. So I don't love the idea of getting all these monthly payments. And the financial planner in me, it just comes out of me when I see people doing this. I'm like, no, you don't want to finance things over a long period of time, especially if the interest rate is high. You don't want all these monthly payments that are sucking away your income. That sucks away your ability to invest and grow for your future. So I don't love the buy now, pay later phenomenon that is actually exploding right now. I don't think that it is a great idea. But on the other end, it does make it affordable for you to be able to buy something that maybe you wouldn't typically be able to buy. So when this is 0% interest, I like it a hell of a lot more. But at 20%, 25% interest, I think it's crazy. I think it's ridiculous. So Affirm's stock price has exploded over the last 6 months higher since they announced these partnerships with Amazon and with Walmart and with Target. So the company is doing very well, and there's a good reason for that, because they're charging people 20% interest on purchases. So just read the fine print, be very careful what you're doing. Even though the monthly payment seems affordable, it's obscene to pay 20% interest on the purchase, you know, that you're gonna spread out over 12 months. All right, everyone, that's it for today. I hope that you found this one helpful. Please make sure to subscribe to the channel if you're not subscribed already. Hit that like button if you enjoyed this video. Go over to School of Personal Finance, check out what I'm up to. I would love for you to become part of my education center. Join my test group. Hit me up on LinkedIn. Let's connect over there, and I will see you again in the next video. Thanks.